people won't engage with traditional methods of giving their opinions. If you put a form in front of somebody and say, well, you know, naught is bad and 10 is fantastic, that works for some people, but a lot of people just won't engage with that. But if you say, well, can you express your opinion, your experiences, your life in words, in pictures, in photography, in dance, in music, suddenly it opens up a whole new door and lots of people get involved.
The whole point of the engagement between the health service and the patients and the public is really, it's a plea for the three P's, which is the public, the patient and the professionals. It's to link those three together. The basic idea is to show that communication from the public, from patients to the professionals, is incredibly important, and it works both ways. Sometimes perhaps the patient feels they don't quite understand the doctor's terminology, but often it's the patient's embarrassment or inability sometimes to express properly what they mean that could be a problem for the doctor.
So when we were first approached for Creative Voices, we knew straight away that there'd be loads of individuals and groups that would want to get involved. Harmony and Health and Anne, our local poet, and Richard, our painter, and Friendly of Fleetwood with their little drama group they put together. You know, several more we could have got involved. And we took Creative Voice very literally. We've got loads of creative people, people who love sharing what they can do. And our role is to give them a voice.
Local NHS practices, doctors, social prescribers, they are all fully aware of the benefits and help us to engage with the people. I know how important it is that you go to your GP and they're not just dishing out yet another pill. They're thinking, well, maybe this is a young man who might benefit from helping others. Maybe this lady who's just lost her husband, who may be used to singing a choir, she might benefit from being signposted. And I think that with the social economic climate and with the financially deprived state of the town, with the loss of jobs in the fishing industry and things like that, I think that people have just come together and kind of grabbed onto anything like this that's good for them.
I attend the Lancashire Mental Health Partnership. Now that's led by people with lived experience of mental health, and they've been looking at creative ways to for people to express their journey in mental health. So it's about hearing the voices of people in Lancashire and not just going off and delivering services. It's about really understanding.
I write short stories and poetry, but I write lots of different things on lots of different subjects, but it does help you relieve the stress. The people I write about are characters that don't normally have an animated voice. This poem I've written is about the brain, the different parts of the brain, but they all have a character, and that's how I bring things to life.
I'm writing a book called The Enemy From Within, and it's an illustration book, and I just wanted to help other people with mental health struggles and basically put my voice out there, my story out there. I just wanted to try and make something of myself and show people that there is light at the end of the tunnel, sort of thing.
I think Fleetwood has needed this, and it needs lots more groups as well. Being part, especially of our singing group, it gives people the confidence to just go to the doctors or the practitioners and not be afraid of just speaking and telling them how they feel.